Hey crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Selbel. In this video, I would like to activate an Awair Element sensor with Planetwatch. Today, my voice is probably a little bit affected from a party that we had yesterday night, but I hope you can still understand me clearly. On September 1st, Planetwatch announced that they will support the Awair Element as their Type 4 sensor. One day later, I went onto Amazon and purchased such a sensor that was on Amazon.de in Germany. Now, the delivery time for that was 2 weeks and the price was 153 euro. I guess if you purchase a sensor nowadays somewhere else, because it's currently not available on Amazon, then the delivery time might be longer, the price might be a little bit higher, but I guess it is still a pretty good deal. Planetwatch has got the rule that we can have one of these sensors per household. So there's no point in purchasing multiple sensors and stack them into a rack or something. That's not allowed. Once I had the sensor, I purchased a license. I went to planetwatch.io, buy licenses, and I purchased a Type 4 license because you need exactly this license for the Awair Element sensor. Now it is about 2 months later and Planetwatch has released their new app. They made a great blog post over here about our new mobile app, but some parts in the blog post might be misleading, and they also had to do some bug fixing because a brand new app, it always contains a number of bugs, and they ironed them out in the last 2 days. They also have an instruction for activating the Awair Element, but this is not very detailed. So I thought I record the process of how I activated over here. First of all, I will bring my Android device to the screen because I will download the Awair Home app. So I go to the Play Store, I search for Awair Home, and I click on install to get the app. I can close the browser for now. And once the app is installed, I open it. The first thing I do here is creating an Awair account. I click on sign up and then just walk through the process of creating an account. I'm not going to film that, but I think this is pretty straightforward. Now I've got an account and I will later need it to connect the sensor with Planetwatch. The next thing is connecting the sensor with the app. For that, I click on the blue button, find Awair, and then run through the process of pairing the sensor with my phone. Again, I'm not going to film that, but I guess it's a very straightforward process and I will just go through it. I paired my Awair Elements with the account and now I see the readings of the sensor over here on my phone. That's it for the Awair app at the moment. The next app I need is the Planetwatch app. I already installed the Planetwatch app, but if you have to do that, then you would go to the Google Play Store and search for Planetwatch. And there you would find the Planetwatch app. This is different from the Planetwatch wearable app, which is just for the Atmotube Pro sensor. The one that I need right now is this one, Planetwatch. The login details that I need for the Planetwatch app are the same details that I would need for the Planetwatch Explorer on explorer.planetwatch.io. So if you don't have an account at the Explorer over here, then you would first go here and create an account with the same email address that you used for purchasing your licenses. I already have an account and I can use these credentials to log into the Planetwatch app. I already did that. I have my Arkino sensor over here. This is a sensor that I already installed a few days ago. And now I want to add a new wallet for the Awair sensor. I prefer to keep all my sensors in different wallet accounts so that I have an easy way to keep the overview. So let's go to wallets, then plus to add a new wallet. I don't need to enable biometric right now. I want to create a new account. I will name this account Awair. Now the app shows me my recovery passphrase. It's a 25-word passphrase, and it's super important that I keep this passphrase somewhere really safe, because once I log out of the app will completely forget about my wallet. Yeah, nothing is stored on the Planetwatch servers. So we definitely need to store the passphrase somewhere safe, like in our password managers. The app added my wallet over here. In order to add the Planet asset and later add the sensor to this wallet too, I need a little bit of algos for a transaction fee. From the blog posts of Planetwatch, I understood that they will send the algos to this wallet, but in reality, I don't see that happening. So I will send one algo over here manually. I click on the three dots, I copy the wallet address, and now I go to my main Algorand wallet, which has nothing to do with this app, but it's on the same phone. And over there, I click on algos, I click on send, I say the amount is one algo, and I click on address. I paste the wallet address from the new wallet, and then I can preview the transaction and send the algos. That seems to be completed, so let's go back to the Planetwatch app. And scroll down, and now I see there is one algo. Let's try adding the Planet asset. It says OK, add the Planet asset. It's added. Good. Now I can activate the Awair sensor. I go to sensors and I click on the plus icon on top of the screen. And then I select my type 4 license. I say I want to activate an Awair element. And I click connect to Awair element. Now I am redirected to the Awair account, and I will log in with the credentials that I have chosen for the Awair account. I'm not going to film the credentials over here, but I will fill them in and click on sign in. Okay, it says they have one Awair element over here. I can choose that. I choose a wallet account. This is the Awair wallet account that I just created. Let's choose that. And now I have to supply the address where I am operating this Awair element. I'm not going to film the address details, but I will type them in here. With the details filled in, I click on proceed. And the message says the activation could take up to 2 minutes. So let's wait. Okay, the license is added successfully. View sensor, let's do that. I go to indoor, and there is the Awair element. Awesome. That looks good. It's now 13 days later. Yes, that's almost 2 weeks. I'm now in the Explorer at explorer.planetwatch.io. I want to check together with you how my Awair element is doing. I'm logged in, and under my profile icon, I can select my sensors. And I see all my sensors. And over here is my Awair Element. I see this is Planetwatch AE, which is Awair Element. So let's click that. And here I see that now it is doing fine. I see that the owner last payout is 23.04 planets. And that's fantastic. Over the last 2 weeks, Planetwatch had a problem with that. Their system dropped a lot of data that the Awair Element was delivering, and they couldn't process it. And subsequently, their rewards engine was paying out much too low rewards, sometimes 7 planets, 8 planets, and so on. But 2 days ago, they announced that they had fixed the issue. Today, I see the maximum reward. The stream count over here, it's now 720 out of 720, and that's just a number. That doesn't mean that we will see 720 transactions in our wallets over here. Let's go in there. There's only one transaction per hour. So the timing of Planetwatch right now is one stream per hour, which is quite nice. And we don't have so much clutter in the wallet. Now, 23 planets, let's see what that is. Today I will go to CoinGecko, CoinGecko/coins/Planetwatch. There is the current price of the Planet token. Price is really strong, even though the market in general had a dip, but the Planet is doing fine. So let's see, 23.04 planets. At the current rate, that's $9.62. I think that's a fantastic reward per day. I hope this video can help you when you are thinking about adding an Awair Element to your sensors, or when you have to set it up. Let me know in the comments what you think, and I hope I see you in the next video.